Before independence, Samoa used to operate under the Matai system. Every decision from the Matai Council is finalized without questions from the people. In terms of justice and legal protection, it depends solely on how good the Matais are in representing their families in the Matai Council, and therefore, the rights of the people are not equally exposed to decision-making. This documentary focuses on legal protection using human rights and domestic violence to argue that it is not a barrier to accessing justice. Before independence, Samoa has a dominant figure in the family, which is the man. Specifically, the women and children do not have rights to speak, hencing when domestic violence happens. Resolutions of such problems was solely on the Fa'amatai system, or the Matai Council, to solve, which appears to be unequal due to the gender statistics, which is the belief of the old Fa'asamoa that the man is the superior authority in the family.
She doesn't talk about it because maybe she likes it a little bit. Then justice will never be around. We'll never see it. That's why human rights is about voicing your opinion, voicing what you think is right. What you think is right may not be what I think is right. But voicing what you about expressing yourself, then the more discussion there will be, and then there will be lots of understanding. And people will slowly find ways how to accommodate this.
Most domestic violent cases goes unheard due to the fact that women as well as children are unable to speak of incident that has occurred to them. This may be caused by the growing fear they feel towards the superior gender. In the Fa'amatai system, women and children's voices were not heard, but only of the men. With legal protection put into place, it ensures them that it is okay to speak and let their voices be heard, just as the men are able to voice their opinions regarding a matter. The courts are able to provide protection order as an example to legal protection to provide those who are considered weak so that they are able to speak and be heard without any hesitation or fear. This practice is very effective today, for not only men are able to voice their say, but also women and children are heard. This also solves the social issue of gender inequality or gender bias, and also promotes human rights for women and children. With this new mindset, women and children who have been victimized by domestic violence are able to gain access to justice they truly deserve.
Some communities who say that children don't have any rights to decide for themselves. I think that's a misconception, because the rights of children are basically, it's not for children to make decisions, but it's for children to have access to certain essentials of life, like education, being cared for, to be fed. That's a right of the child. But you know, nowadays you can often hear, adults or those who make decisions in villages saying that the customary.
In conclusion, legal protection is not a barrier in accessing justice in Samoa. Using domestic violence and human rights, it is seen that back in history, people find it hard to access fair justice due to suppression of women and children's voices of opinions. Nowadays, through the introduction of human rights, domestic violence has unfair access to justice for resolutions, whereby women and children are given rights to voice their opinions in regards of the issue. Hence, that legal protection is not a barrier to accessing justice in Samoa nowadays. Minaka valevu faftai to fasu shu.